Question. First of all, read the question, okay? 800 microampere. A meter has internal resistance of 100 ohm. Okay, first of all, that is ammeter RM. What about IM? IM is 100 microampere. And what about RM? That is 100 ohm. For extending its range, its range to be measured 500 microampere. If range are extended, means shunt resistance are attached. That is RSH, and that is RM, that is IM, and that is external current like this one. Okay. Determine the value. What about extended range? That is 500 microampere. Determine the value of shunt resistance. Okay. Our motto, determine shunt resistance. What should resistance to be added in shunt? Okay, our motto, determine RSH. How to determine RSH? I know that I this equal to IM plus ISH. Okay, you know M this equal multiplying factor this equal to I by IM. It means that is 500 divided by 100, it is 5. Clear? Okay, now I this equal to IM plus ISH divided by IM in both side, we got that is M ISH this equal to M minus 1 into IM. Clear? What about R ISH? IS, if voltage across V, voltage across RM is V, both are parallel, so IM is written as V divided by RM and ISH is written as V divided by RSH. Okay, these values are put in here. V divided by RSH, this is equal to M minus 1 into V divided by RM. Okay, now RSH this is equal to RM divided by M minus 1. What about M? M this equal to 5. Sorry. RM is 100. And that is 5 minus 1. That is 100 divided by 4. That is 25 ohm. RM is 25 ohm. That is 25 ohm. This is the final answer. Responding to question. First of all, read the question. 2 voltmeter have same range. 2 voltmeter has same range. What about range? That is 400 volt. The internal impedance are 32 kilo ohm and 18 kilo ohm. First one, that is Z1 and that is Z2. It's they are connected in series. If both are connected in series, means Z1 and Z2 like this one. They are connected in series and 500 volt, that is 500 volt, okay, it is clear. If both are connected in series, then what about voltmeter reading or change? Okay, voltmeter without connected in series, range is 400, but if connected in series, what about range? Range is change. It depends upon current I and supply voltage. I this equal to 500 divided by Z1 plus Z2. 500 divided by Z1 and Z2. What about Z1? 32 and that is 80. 18. 10 to power minus 3. That is 500 divided by 15 to 10 to power minus 3. What about I? That is 10 to power minus 2 ampere. Or you can say that that is 10 milliampere. Okay. What about reading, voltmeter reading of Z1 and what about voltmeter reading of Z2? V1 I into Z1 10 milliampere into 32 kilo ohm. We got 320 volt. And what about V2 I into Z2? I is 10 milliampere. And what about Z2, that is 18 kilo ohm, that is 180 volt. Okay, first is 320, a second is 180 volt right now. Corresponding to question, a 50 microampere meter movement with an internal resistance, that is IM, 50 microampere. And what about voltmeter reading? That is RM. VM is written as 50 microampere into what about RM? RM is 1 kilo ohm. Finally, we got 0.5 volt. Okay. Corresponding to question, is to be used as a DC voltmeter of range 50 volt. Okay. Determine multiplying if voltmeter reading is changed, it means series resistance is added. That is RM and that is RS. Our motto determine multiplying resistance required. Multiplying resistance means series resistance are required. Our motto determine series resistance, then voltmeter multiplying factor means V upon VM. Okay, that is VM. If series resistance are connected, suppose that is VS. That is Vs upon Rs plus Rm. What about Vm? Vm is written as I into Rm. That is Vs into Rm divided by Rs plus Rm. Okay. What about Vm? Vm is 0.05. What about Vs? That is 50. And what about Rm? That is 1 kilo ohm. Divided by what about Rs? That is 1. We got Rs this equal to 99 kilo ohm. Okay, Rs is 99 kilo ohm, 999 kilo ohm. Okay, what about multiplying factor? M this equal to V upon Vm. V is 50 and that is 0.5. finally we got 1000. That is 1000, that is final unit less. Okay. An iron choke take 4 ampere current when connected to a 20 volt DC supply. First of all, this is choke or coil, you can say that like this one. Inductor and resistance are present like this one. But in case of DC, in case of DC, inductor behave as a short circuit, current draw from supply, that is 4 ampere, connected to a 20 volt DC supply like this one, that is 20, that is 20 volt, that is resistance. Okay, RL. What about RL? That is 20 divided by 4, that is 5 ohm, that is 5 ohm. When connected to a 65 volt 50 hertz AC supply, in case of AC coil, inductance are present, that's why JXL. Okay, Now here is connected to 65 volt 50 hertz. Okay, what about current magnitude? That is given 5 ampere. Our motto, determine the power drop from the coil. Okay, means active, reactive and apparent power. What about R? R is 5 ohm. With the help of AC, what about Z? Z is equal to V by I. V by I, that is 65 divided by 5. 65 divided by 5, that is 13 ohm. Z is equal to under root R square plus XL. So what about XL? That is Z square minus R square. What about Z? Z is 13. And what about R? R is 5. That is, finally we got 12. That is 12 ohm. R is equal to 5. XL is equal to 12 ohm. Okay. Now, power factor 5. That is 12, 5 and that is 13. Clear? Now, cos phi, 5 by 13, sin phi, 12 by 13. Power draw, real power draw by choke, or you can say that coil. P is equal to VI cos phi. What about V? That is 65 and that is 5 and 5 by 13. Okay. That is 125 watt. Okay. Now, reactive power. Reactive power drawn. Draw by choke, or you can say that coil. Q is equal to VI sin phi. What about V? 65, that is 5 and 12 by 13. We got, that is 300 VAR. Okay. What about apparent power? Apparent power by coil or choke, that is VI 65 into 5, that is 325 VA. This one and this one is the answer. Okay.